What happened here?
Our friend Jigsaw thought he could make an anorexic man healthy. Only one problem.
What's that?
He kidnapped the wrong guy.
That I like to call manorexia. Definition: anorexia for men. Shut up! You've been a skinny fuck all your life. We need to fatten you up and put some meat on you, boy. Get you fanned up. In front of you is a bunch of food on a weighing scale. If all the food is not consumed, the devices above you will end your miserable life. Will you be willing to let go of your disorder and finally eat? Never die. Make your choice. Whoa, wait! Wait, what the fuck are you doing? You can't just walk out of here! No!
Excuse me. Hoffman, talk to me. Wait, slow down. Right now? Alright, Gordon and I are on our way. Just lay out the victim!
What?
I'll call you back.
Where are they?
Let's go. A bomb went off when the victim failed to gas.
Son of a bitch, we're dealing with a sick bastard.
And all because she was a Twilight fan.
Wait, you're saying the victim was a Twilight fan?
Unfortunately.
Well, then I immediately take back what I said.
Twilight, and I find that very annoying. Why are you so annoying? Today you must face your obsession. I'm going to quiz you on the Twilight movie, asking you a series of questions. Your goal is to get a score lower than 25%. Are you ready to let go of your obsession? If not, it will destroy you. Let the game begin. First question. What color is Bella's prom dress? Come on, answer it, damn it. What color is Bella's prom dress?
Blue.
That is correct. Remember, you want to get the questions wrong in order to make it out of here. Next question. And how many bites did Bella swallow her granola bar the morning after she discovered Edward was a vampire?
It's three.
Am I not getting through to you, dammit? Let go! So damn annoying! You better not get this next question right. Okay, Thaddeus. What does blood smell like to Bella? We're not even gonna get through the 10 questions, fuck it. Yeah!
That.
Oh
yeah.
Hate it when it does that.
Oh god.
Stay here.
All she had to do was answer the questions wrong.
What an idiot.
I wouldn't talk, Commissioner Gordon.
How big is your penis, Commissioner Gordon?
Hello? Wait, you're saying you have a lead on the Jigsaw Killer's location? When is the song buying Porto Max at 7-Eleven on 25th Street?
What are we waiting for?
Let's go!
My penis is surely bigger than yours.
Why? That's impossible, Commissioner Gordon. I'm huge.
He's got three arms. We're no match for him.
You weren't kidding.
Concerned about your problem over there.
Over here?
No, over there.
Over there?
Where? Look where I'm pointing. God damn it! I don't have time to deal with this bullshit today. Yes, right there.
Daddy,
it's your son, James.
Little
Gordon! No!
Yes, it's little Gordon.
What do you want? What is this?
What do I want? My face on the $1 bill.
You must be joking.
Do I look like I'm joking? Well, after all, you should know what I want by now. After all, this isn't the first game of mine you've been a part of. Dr. Gordon?
That's Commissioner Gordon.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hello, Commissioner Gordon. For years, you've been snorting and sniffing your way down a dark path into despair through your cocaine addiction.
Here comes the Gordon!
I have no idea how you're still the Commissioner of Gotham City Police. You have a mask on, one of my favorites. You have 5 minutes to find the key to unlock it. The irony is that you must follow your nose and face your addiction in order to save your life. If you don't find it in under 5 minutes, the mask will pull your mustache straight off your face. Make your choice.
Thank you.
Congratulations, mustache man. You still have your mustache. What in God's name are you doing? Stop it! Stop it immediately. Now what is he doing?
I need it!
Aren't you forgetting about your son, Gordon?
Cook is my only son! What do you want?
What I want? I want to play a game. Time to play the game. Time to play the game! It's all about the game, and how you play it. It's all about controlling it, you can take it. It's all about your debt, and if you can pay it. It's all about paying and who's gonna make it. I'm the game, you don't wanna play me. I am control, no way can you change me. I am the debt, no way can you pay me. I am the pain, I know you can't take me. Look up your shoulder, ready to run. I can give it a bitch when I'm running on. I am the game and I make the rules. So move on out here and die like a fool. Try to figure out what the move's gonna be. Come on, little sucker, why don't you ask me? Don't you forget there's a price you could pay. Cause I am the game and I want to play. Time to play the game.
Domination?
You're quite the partier at your school.
I like how you dress. How about we heat it up in here?
Tempting, but I have herpes. You devote all your time to partying. I call you unworthy of the opportunity that you have. I should be the one going to college, dammit!
Well, then you should come visit me.
I like that. In fact, we can get jiggy with it. No, wait. No, first you must learn a lesson that life is not all about fun and games.
But isn't that what your life's about?
Oh my
games?
God. Let's not make this about me. This is about you. This is why you're here. The irony is that you must show me how wild you can get in this game. I want to play some Twister.
I got it.
Are you enjoying this game? Spin it, damn it! It's
yeah.
Times like these when you're glad that you're alive. I haven't done this in years.
This is so fun.
I am so grateful to be alive.
What's the problem?
It's all bullshit, you know? No one comes out of this rejuvenated.
On the contrary, they do.
Yeah?
Name one person who's changed their ways.
You know, I started doing what I do.
Didn't answer my question there.
I was diagnosed with the disease rotting me on the inside.
Brain cancer?
Actually, no. Genital herpes. People take their lives, namely their sex lives, for granted. In an instant, it can all be taken away from you.
When, what?
From that point forward, I knew I had to do what I do. You take a look at a hot chick on the street and realize that you can never have them the same way again. I knew I'd spend the rest of my days testing the fabric of human nature. So, take a look for yourself, Commissioner.
I'll look.
Hi, I'm jigSAW, and I have genital herpes. But that doesn't stop me from playing games. Genital herpes can affect the penis, scrotum, vulva, vagina, anus, urethra, pouch, thighs, and the buttocks. However, many people mistake herpes symptoms for other predicaments such as a vaginal yeast infection, a jock itch, insect bites, hemorrhoids, or an ingrown hair. I have herpes, and he doesn't. That's why I'm going to make sure that he stays symptom-free. Symptoms of genital herpes include an itching or burning feeling in the genital or anal area, flu-like symptoms including fever, swollen glands, pain in the legs, buttocks, or genital area, vaginal discharge, and a feeling of pressure in the area below the stomach. Protect your partner from your disgusting outbreaks. I'd rather die from a reverse bear trap than see another outbreak of mine. Nothing is worse than seeing herpes once active. But I've been outbreak-free for almost a year. That's why I use genitalinol. To relieve the symptoms of an outbreak, and to make sure that my partner stays herpes-free. Chances are that you have herpes, and genitalinol is for you. If you experience several outbreaks a year, then you'll benefit from taking this medication every day. If you call right now and order a large box of genitalinol, you'll get another large box almost absolutely free. Take this medication, and you can go back to enjoying outdoor activities with your loved one.
Tag your ass.
Maybe you'll even appear in a herpes commercial yourself. Genitalinol is available in all 50 U.S. states, even Alaska. A little effort would be nice. Side effects of genitalinol may include shrunken testicles, high blood pressure, and massive diarrhea. That commercial gave me the funding necessary to start my little games, but I was still short a little bit of cash. Hi, I'm jigSAW. These are my rocket skates. Some people are so ungrateful to be alive, but not me. Not anymore. Once I had my full funding to start my days as a therapist, I needed an insurance policy. I needed to find myself an apprentice, just in case I suddenly died from my disease.
Oh, where am I?
Oh, what the fuck? There's so much shit!
Oh, janitor. If you want to be my apprentice of the week, you have to pass a test. I want to see if you have what it takes to survive. You have 60 seconds to unclog my toilet for me. If the toilet is not unclogged at the end of 60 seconds, I'll leave you here to rot with a stench. Let the games begin.
Much in the view! Why don't you touch? Ah, so good! Ah,
Congratulations, you have survived my shitty game. Shitty game, get it?
Enough of this nonsense!
Here comes the Gordon!
Oh no! Oh no!
Ah! Oh no!
Ah! Ah!
Where to now?
Oh, we're not even moving. There's the house. There's the house.
James, you don't remember me, but I used to know you really well, better than anyone else. That's because I'm you, your former self. You quickly turned me into a memory with your drug addiction and your lack of effort to kick the drugs.
Here comes the Gordon!
People take their lives for granted. In an instant, it can all be taken away from you. For years, you've been snorting and sniffing your way down a dark path into despair through your cocaine addiction.
It's all bullshit, you know? No one comes out of this rejuvenated.
On the contrary, they do. How big is your penis, Commissioner Gordon?
Enough of this nonsense!
Oh.
What do you want?
I
want
to play a game. Hello, Paul Thaddeus. Janitor, Commissioner Gordon.
Piranha.
I have no idea how you're still allowed to be the police commissioner of Gotham City. Congratulations, Mustache Man.
Now you're alone, locked away to rot.
I needed an insurance policy.
You...
me.
Want some coke?
No!
Game over.
I'll fucking kill you! I'll fucking kill you!